This is a rubber band powered car, and this is an egg. Moments before, I attempted to make it go 10 meters for egg racing. Now, a rubber band powered car works by storing potential energy when it is being wound around the axle. Releasing the axle allows the rubber band to quickly unwind, spinning the axle, and thus the stored potential energy is converted into kinetic energy and the car is propelled forward. Originally, building a rubber band powered car isn't a big deal. I have built many of them before in the past, but my tech teacher has just given us a project to make a rubber band powered car that can go 10 meters while carrying an egg. So that's quite an upgrade. Now, to pass the test, this rubber band powered car has to be able to do two things, which is be able to carry an egg, go 10 meters while carrying the egg, and of course it has to be powered by a rubber band. This sure sounds like a big deal, but as they say, it's always impossible till you start. So let's start building it. Here, I'm wrapping the back wheels with some rubber pieces to help it gain more traction, because the original tires I used slips a lot and do not gain enough traction. Now that our rubber band powered car is complete, all that is left for us to be the carriage for the egg, which I already made one, and let's just install it. The carriage design is pretty basic and it does get the job done, which is to carry the egg safely and stop it from falling or breaking. Once we've installed this, let's go test the car to see how far this design can go.
Ready to test it over this distance of 10 meters. And just so you know how far this is for a rubber band powered car.
This is the car from the other end of the track, so it's quite a distance for a rubber band powered car.
This is our first test to see how far this car can go without the egg on it, so. The car only managed to go about 1.5 meters without the egg on it. Let's try with the egg on it then. And now when the egg is placed on it, the car managed to go an extra meter, going up to 2.5 meters. Now you might be wondering why the car goes an extra distance even when some weight was added on it. Here's why. Now notice that the tires, even though I have added some rubber band on it, still skid, trying to gain traction. This is because of how aggressive the pull from the rubber band is. It's just like a car, when you slam on the gas too much, the tires skid, trying to gain traction before the car starts to move. Unfortunately for this car, by the time it gets any traction, it has already started decelerating, which is why it doesn't go very far. Now, when the egg was put on it, you can see that the car still skids, trying to gain traction, but it's much reduced, because the weight of the egg pushes the car downward, forcing the tires to be more in contact with the ground, which is why the car managed to go an extra distance. This is in fact our first issue with this rubber band powered car design. Another issue I notice with this rubber band powered car design is the elastic limit of the rubber band. By that I mean how much it can stretch. At maximum, it can only manage to stretch up to this point. If I try to force it to go beyond, the rubber band snaps. If the rubber band was maybe able to wrap around the axle up to this point, maybe it would have gone further. From the results of the two cars using this rubber band powered design, it was pretty frustrating. If I was going to score myself, this was going to be a 1.5 over 10 or 2.5 over 10, which is pretty much an F. But as a good engineer, I had to find a solution to this. By now, I've only managed to tick one of the boxes in our checklist, which is to make the car carry an egg. So I have to figure out how to complete the other two objectives. So I began to research on projects like this that might have been done in the past and to see if it actually went 10 meters. Unfortunately, I couldn't find any. I did see this mousetrap powered car that went up to a whopping 35 meters, but unfortunately, it was powered by a mousetrap and not a rubber band, so it wasn't an option for me. I continued with my research but still couldn't find any answers, so I decided to take a break and go through my channel. And doing so, I found this. Before I explain what I mean, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, this would be a good time to do so. I would really appreciate it if you took your time to subscribe. It really supports me and encourages me to do more. So going through my channel, I found this rubber band powered plane I had built before, and since it was still powered by rubber band, I decided to inspect it. Looking at the way the propeller was being powered by the rubber band gave me an idea on what to do to probably make this car go 10 meters. As you can see, instead of the rubber band to be wrapped around the axle like our regular rubber band powered car, it was instead twisted, and it seems to have a lot of tolerance on how much you can twist it. Also, when the propellers were released, it didn't just reach maximum acceleration like with our rubber band powered car. It kind of supplied power to the propeller at a constant acceleration, which could be the answer to our rubber band powered car going 10 meters. So I immediately got to work to install this design on our rubber band powered car. I discovered I had to transmit motion to the axle at a 90 degree angle, which is why I'm using these gears. After fixing the gears in place, I hooked up the rubber band and gave it some spin to see how well it performed, and it turned out great. The wheels seemed to spin without any friction. So it was time for me to go test this car to see if it could go 10 meters and hopefully help me pass my test. I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.